Hello guys, in today's video I'll show you how to use CrystalDiskInfo. To download CrystalDiskInfo, go to Google. Now search for CrystalDiskInfo and click on the first link, or you can directly go to this website. Next, go to Downloads and download the standard version. Next, go to the downloaded folder and double click on the installation file. Next, accept the license agreement. Next, select the folder where you want to install the software. Now, click on Install to install the software. If you want to install the software directly from the Microsoft Store, first, go to the Microsoft Store and search for Crystal. Next, select CrystalDiskInfo. Now, click the Install button to install the software. After installing, open the software. So, this is the interface of CrystalDiskInfo. Now, let me give you a basic rundown of the interface. This section gives you the basic information like the brand and total capacity of your hard disk or SSD. In this section, you can find all the in-depth details like firmware, serial number, interface, drive letter, and many other details. In this section, you can find the current status and the current temperature of your hard disk or SSD. In this section, you get all the attributes that are related to your hard disk or SSD. In this section, you can find all the hard disks that are connected to your system, including the external hard disk. To hide the serial number, go to Function and then select the option Hide Serial Number. If you want CrystalDiskInfo to run on Startup, go to Function. Next, select the option Startup. If you open the system tray, we can find all the hard disk temperatures. Now, if you don't want this to show up, go to Function and deselect the option Keep Running in System Tray. There are three different refresh functions that we will be seeing. The first one is Refresh. This option will refresh only the values of the selected drive. The next one is Auto Refresh. This option will refresh all the values of all the connected drives according to the time set. For example, if you set Auto Refresh to 1 minute, then it will refresh all the values every minute. The last one is Auto Refresh Target. This option will enable you to select or deselect the drive that you want to enable or disable for auto refresh. To scan for newly connected hard drives, go to Function and select the option Rescan. To change Celsius to Fahrenheit, go to the Advanced feature under the Function. Next, go to Temperature Type and select the option Fahrenheit. To change the theme, go to the Theme option and select Green Mode for green icons. And for dark background, select Dark under Theme. To set alerts, go to Function and then select the option Alert Features and enable the option Alert Sound. Next, go to Sound Setting to add the custom alert sound. Now, click on the music icon and select a sound from your library. Now, if you want to preview the sound, click on the Play button. Next, you can adjust the volume of the alert using the slide bar. After adjusting, click OK. Next, go to the Advanced feature under Function and select the option Health Status Setting. Now, for SSD, set the remaining life to 15 and apply it. And for HDD hard disk, set the first three values to 1 and apply it. Again, go to the Advanced feature under Function and select the option Alarm Temperature. Now for SSD, set the value to 60°. And for HDD hard disk, set it to 50 and then apply it. For the final step, go to Auto Refresh under the function and set any one of the time intervals. To export the data in text format, go to File and select the option Save Text. If you want the data in image format, first select the hard drive that you want the data for. Next, go to File and select the option Save Image. If you have any hard disk with a health status as caution or bad, it is better to backup your data or transfer your data to a new drive. Thank you for watching, guys. See you in the next video.